नमस्कार एवरीबॉडी, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. वनकम. वी मीट अगेन ऑन दिस वंस अगेन ऑन दिस ब्यूटीफुल सैटरडे. टुडे वी विल बी डूइंग समथिंग डिफरेंट. आई नो ऑल ऑफ यू एंड मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर एक्चुअली पार्टिसिपेटिंग इन डेली क्लासेस. अनुराधा வந்து கிளாஸ்ல வந்து ஜாயின் பண்ணிட்டீங்க. Anuradha's class, and also most of you have been practicing at home and all these things. So what I'm going to do today is I'm going to take a different approach in the way that we are actually going to do the practice today. We are going to do a bit of asana, normal Surya Namaskar and everything, and then I'm going to do a light meditation session. I'm going to teach you how to do concentration practice at home, and what is the benefit of this meditation and what is the technique. இது எல்லாமே வந்துட்டு I will go through very thoroughly with you today. I think this session will be very, very useful to almost many of us. Why? Because the mental health of the people, not only during this period but also at other times, had been quite detrimental. கொஞ்சம் நிறைய பேர்த்துக்கு வந்துட்டு இஷ்யூ வரதே வந்துட்டு இங்க ஒருத்தர் இருக்கான், இவனை வந்து கண்ட்ரோல் பண்ண முடியாதனாலதான். ஸோ இவனை எப்படி கண்ட்ரோல் பண்றது, இவனை எப்படி பக்குவத்துக்கு கொண்டு வருது, நல்ல ஒரு கான்சென்ட்ரேஷனான நிலைக்கு வந்துட்டு எப்படி கொண்டு வருது அப்படின்றது தான் வந்துட்டு இஸ் கோயிங் டு பி அவர் கோ பிராக்டிஸ் டுடே. ஸோ ஐ வாண்ட் ஆல் ஆஃப் யூ டு ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஹேவ் சம் நோட்ஸ் ஆர் வாட் பேன் ஆர் எனி திங் லைக் தட். To prepare yourself, if you haven't brought it yet, go and bring it. I'll give you some time so that you can prepare your notes or anything. Remember, all these thing that I'm going to tell you, or I always tell in classes, or I always teach in classes, you must remember, not only my class, in any class that you actually try, be it yoga or be it any other things, always remember to take notes, because lot of knowledge is lost in translation when you actually verbally saying or giving instructions, and then you are intaking it at that moment only. But other than that, neenga marubadiyum poiittu payirchi pandrathukku illa neenga marubadiyum poiittu seiyrathukku vandittu you would not be able to recall the steps. So when you have your own notes in the way that you understand, when you write it down in the way that you understand, you will be able to have better grasp of the subject. Okay, so I think all of you are ready. There is a number of you all who have not switched on your cameras, your videos. I will need you to switch on your videos. I need to know who's behind these names. I want to see your calm and composed face in the morning. Do you know all these? We have heard a lot of things about smiling and laughing, a lot of things, isn't it? You can do all types of exercise. Some exercise are related to the joint, some exercise are related to the muscle, some exercise related to the parts of the body, to the internal organs. But the only exercise that is the most important and the only thing that you can do that can exercise the facial muscle, you know what it is, isn't it? What it is? It is smiling. It is very important to smile. Under all circumstances, and also when you are doing a practice, when you are doing asana, whatever that you actually do, when you are smiling, it means you are cherishing that moment. And every single moment in your life is something to be cherished for. Actually, if you know how to live totally, if you want to live totally, you must remember that every moment in your life is something to be cherished for. So what you need to do, everything that you do, you must have joy gleaming in your face. It must reflect in your face. It is the very first thing that you must remember in all that you do. If you are cooking, if you are going outside for a walk, if you are talking to someone, every single thing, you always have to have a light smile and always be in that state of joy. This is the very exercise. This is the best exercise that you can do for your face. Those who smile will never age. These are the words of my gurus. Those who smile and those who are always showing happiness, reflecting happiness through their face, will never age. Those who do not want to age, you can always keep your smile on. If you feel that I want to get old, then it's up to you. Once again, I welcome those who just joined. Let us start our practice today. As usual, with joint exercises. I'm going to lead you today, step by step, into the practice of meditation. We are not going to do asanas today, not going to do a lot of asanas today. We are going to focus on the practice of controlling this bigger faculty over here. Okay, so sit in a comfortable position. Keep your back straight. Sit in a comfortable position. Keep your back straight. It is raining here. I'm not sure if it is raining in your place. I think it's a very good mood for meditation. Not for sleeping, yeah? Sit in a comfortable position. Close your eyes and keep your spine straight. Relax the shoulders. Relax your facial muscle. Soften your face. Take few deep inhalation and exhalation. Set your intention. What is the very purpose that you are doing this practice today? It is to be healthy. It is to be composed. It is to be calm. Prepare yourself for the next 1.5 hours for the practice of yoga. Prepare yourself for the next 1.5 hours for the practice of yoga. Breathing in. Breathing out. In. Out. In. Out. Now, slowly open your eyes. Extend your feet forward. We'll have to do joint exercise first. Palms facing on the opposite direction. Inhale, toes forward. Exhale towards your body. Inhale, toes forward. Exhale towards your body. Inhale, feet forward. Exhale towards your body. Inhale, feet forward. Exhale towards your body. Feet slightly apart, toes pointed at each other. Inhale, rotate all the way towards the sides and then exhale to the center. From the inside, inhale, rotate all the way towards the sides and then exhale to the center. Now bring your feet together once again. Do a circle clockwise. Ankle rotation. All these joint exercises very important to ensure proper circulation of blood towards all the parts of the body, towards all these joints. Do the other way around. Done. Point your toes towards your body. Hands on your knees. Inhale, engage your kneecap until the heels are lifted. Exhale, release. Inhale, engage your kneecap until the heels are lifted. Exhale, release. Now bend your right leg. Interlock your fingers. Place it behind your right thigh. Inhale, straighten up your right leg. Exhale, place it on the opposite direction. Inhale, straighten up. Exhale, place it on the right side. Inhale, straighten up. Exhale, place it on top of your left thigh. Right hand on your right knee. Inhale, press your knee down. Exhale, bring it close towards your chest. Inhale, press your knee down. Exhale, bring it close towards your chest. Do hip rotation clockwise. Anti-clockwise, the other way around. Not rush, do it slowly. You're not going anywhere. Stop, extend the legs forward. Bend your left leg, interlock your fingers, place it behind your left thigh. Inhale, straighten up your left leg. Exhale, place it on the opposite direction. Inhale, straighten up. Exhale, place it on the left side. Inhale, straighten up. Exhale, place it on top of your right thigh. Left hand on your left knee. Inhale, press your knee down. Exhale, bring it close towards your chest. Inhale, press your knee down. Exhale, bring it close towards your chest. Do hip rotation clockwise. Anti-clockwise, that way round. Stop, extend your legs forward, bring the soles of your feet together. This is called Tirthalyasana. Bring it as close as possible towards your groin area. Now, interlock your fingers, place it in front of your toes, and then go up, down. Stop, hands on your knees, elbows pointed upwards, look up, inhale, press your knee down, press, exhale, release. Once again, inhale, press your knee down, press, exhale, release. Extend your legs forward, right leg over left leg, pull back your leg. Now keep your spine straight. The spine straight, pull back your abdomen slightly. Hands up, palms up. Inhale, exhale, bring your fingers close towards your wrist. Inhale, bring your palms up. Exhale, bring it close towards your wrist. Inhale, bring your palms up. Your thumb in, cover up your thumb using the rest of your fingers. Do a wrist rotation clockwise. Anti-clockwise, the other way around. Stop, hands on your shoulders, elbow in line with your shoulder. Inhale, open up with resistance like someone is trying to stop you from opening up. Spread out your fingers, stretch your hands. Exhale, closing in with resistance like someone is trying to stop you from closing in. On your shoulders, elbows together. Inhale, up, rotate all the way towards the sides. Interlock your fingers behind your back, open up your chest. Look up, exhale all the way down towards the center. From downwards, inhale, rotate all the way towards the sides, interlock your fingers behind your back, open up your chest, look up, exhale all the way up towards the center. Now your neck, all the way up, all the way down, to the center, to the right, to the center, to the left, to the center, tilt to the right, to the center, tilt to the left, to the center. Make a circle clockwise, roll. The other way around. To the center, interlock your fingers. Thumbs up. Eyes follow the thumb all the way up. All the way down. To the center. And over towards the right. Eyes focus on the right thumb. Bring it over towards the left. Eyes focus on the left thumb. to the center. Make a circle clockwise, eyes follow your thumb. Anti-clockwise, the other way around. To the center. Inhale, exhale, bring your tongue close towards the tip of your nostril. Both eyes focus at the tip of your nostril. Inhale, bring it back to the center. Exhale, place it at the space in between your eyebrows. Press slightly, look up. Both eyes focus upwards. This is known as Shambhavi. Please relax. Up, Hatha Yoga Surya Namaskar. Now, keep your legs slightly apart, your toes pointed forward, relax your shoulders, bring both your palms together, pull in your abdomen slightly, project your chest forward, close your eyes, do your prayers, thank the universe, your parents, your fellow practitioners, your teachers, your siblings, the nature for giving you the opportunity to practice, for giving you good health, prosperity and happiness. Pray for the well-being of all the people in this world, those that we love, Allah, open your eyes, breathing in, sideways up, your hands all the way up, breathing out towards the center of your chest. Breathing in, stretch forward all the way back. Breathing out all the way down. Take your time, do not rush. Follow your breath. Now bring your right leg all the way back. Left knee down, left knee down. Left knee projecting. Inhale, open up your chest. This breathing started. Don't overwhelm yourself. Hands down, left leg all the way back. On your toes, knee up, exhaling, Shavasana, mountain position. Keep your hands strong, hold your breath, now bring your knee down, your chest down, and your chin down, Sthanasana. Flatten your body, come up until your navel point, this is known as Bhujangasana. Exhale, sit on your heels, with your hands extended forward. This is Shashankarasana. Inhale, come up on all fours, on your toes, knee up, exhaling, Varudarasana. Once again. Now bring the right leg forward in between the hands. Left knee down, left leg down. Right knee projecting, inhale, release. Hands down, left leg forward. Keep your legs slightly apart. Namaskar Kutunga. Inhale, up, all the way up. Exhale, all the way down. Take your time. Now bring your left leg all the way back. Left knee down, left knee down. Left knee projecting, inhale, open up. Hands down. Right leg all the way back. On your toes, knee up, exhaling, Parottasana, mounted posture. Hold your breath, knee down, chest down, and your chin down, Hastanangasana. Inhale, Bhujangasana, up and your navel point. Exhale, Shashankarasana, sit on your heels. Inhale, up, Madhyasana, head pose, look up. On your toes, knee up, exhaling, Parottasana, mountain posture. Now bring your left leg forward in between your hands. The right knee down, right knee down. Left knee projecting. Inhale, open up your chest. Hands down. Right leg forward. With a slight gap in between the legs. Bring your palms together. Inhale up all the way back. Exhale all the way down. go down completely.
Now bring your right leg all the way back. Right knee down, right feet down. Inhale, open up your chest. Hands down, left leg all the way back. Knee up. Exhaling, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Hold your breath, knee down, your chest down, and your chin down, Astangasana. Inhale, Bhujangasana, up until your navel point. Exhale, Shashankasana, sit on your heels. Inhale, up, Marjariasana, cat pose, come up. On your toes, knee up, exhaling, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Now bring your right leg forward. Inhale, open up. Hands down. Left leg forward. Bring both your palms together. Inhale, up all the way back. Exhale, all the way down. Left leg all the way back. Left knee down, left feet down. Inhale, open up. Exhale, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Hold your breath, knee down, chest down, and your chin down, Astangasana. Inhale, Bhujangasana, up until your navel point. Pranishakam lower. Exhale, Shashankasana, sit on your heels. Inhale, up, Marjariasana, cat pose. On your toes, knee up, exhaling, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Now bring the left leg forward. Inhale, open up your chest. Hands down, right leg forward. Bring your palms together, inhale, up all the way back, faster pace. Exhale, all the way down, right leg all the way back, right knee down, right feet down. Inhale, open up. Exhale, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Hold your breath, knee down, chest down, chin down. Inhale, Bhujangasana. Exhale, Shashankasana. Inhale, up, Marjariasana. Exhale, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Now bring your right leg forward in between your hands. Left knee down, left feet down. Inhale, open up. Hands down, left leg forward. Keep both your palms together. Inhale, up all the way back. Exhale, all the way down, left leg all the way back. Inhale, open up. Exhale, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Hold your breath, knee down, your chest down, and your chin down, Astangasana. Inhale, Bhujangasana, come up until your navel point. Exhale, Shashankasana, sit on your heels. Inhale, up, Marjariasana, cat pose, come up. On your toes, bring your knees up, exhaling, Parvatasana, mountain posture. Now bring your left leg forward in between your hands. Inhale, open up. Hands down, right leg forward. Bring both your palms together. Inhale, up all the way back. Exhale to the center of your chest. Inhale, sideways up. Exhale to the center of your chest. Release, relax, drink water if you want to. Prepare for Ashtanga Surya Namaskar A. Ashtanga Surya Namaskar A. Samasti Dihi.
Bring both your feet together, engage your shin, calf. Make sure the ankles are touching one another. The inner ankles are touching one another. The thigh is rolled inwards. Pull back your abdomen. Project your chest forward. Keep your hands at the side of your feet. Look forward. Breathing in, raise your hands all the way up. Breathing out all the way down. And place it at the side of your feet. If you feel uncomfortable, place it on your ankle. Head down completely. Inhale, release and elongate the spine forward, look forward. Bend your knees until your hands are touching the ground. Jump out or bring your right leg and left leg. Lower your body. Inhaling, upward facing. Straight hands. Keep your knee off the ground. Exhaling, downward facing. Now press your heel towards the ground. Spread out your fingers. Make sure your knees are straight. Keep your hands strong, shoulders strong. Project your chest towards the space in between your legs. Breathe deeply. Take deep inhalation and exhalation. If you're very comfortable with this posture, then suck in your abdomen, pull in your abdomen, and then concentrate the breath on the chest. Breathe deeply. One.
Two. Three. Four. Five. Look up slightly, bend your knees, jump in or bring your right leg and left leg forward. Head up, inhale, keep your head up. Exhale, go down completely. Inhale, raise your hands above your head, come up. Exhale, samasthitihi, original position. Now second one. Breathing in, raise your hands all the way up. Breathing out all the way down, head down completely. Breathing in, raise your head up, elongate your spine forward. Bend your knees until your hands are touching the ground. Jump out or bring your right leg and left leg all the way back. Now lower your body, hover above the ground, Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhaling, come up, Utva Mukha Shavanasana. Exhaling, go down, Adho Mukha Shavanasana. Downward facing dog. Now once again, breathe deeply. Keep your knees straight. Engage your kneecap. Strong shoulders. Breathe deeply. One, continue pressing the heel towards the ground. Spread out your fingers so that you get better base. Two. Three. Deep inhalation and exhalation. Four. And five. Look up slightly, bend your knees. Jump in or bring your right leg and left leg forward. Keep your head up. Exhaling, go down completely. Inhaling, raise your hands above your head, look up. Exhaling, samasthitihi. Steady. Now last one, third one. Samasthitihi, Astanga Surya Namaskar. A. Breathing in, raise your hands above your head, soften your face. Exhaling all the way down, head down completely. Inhaling, raise your head up. Bend your knees until your hands are touching the ground. Jump out or bring your right leg and left leg all the way back. Lower your body, Chaturanga. Utva Mukha Shavanasana. Inhale. Adho Mukha Shavanasana. Exhale, downward facing dog. Now once again, breathe. First, ensure the alignments. And then you focus on your breath. Keep your kneecap engaged. Spread out the fingers. Your shoulders strong. Your elbows straight. Pressing the heel towards the ground. The sitting bone, your buttock should move towards the sky. Like you're pointing it towards the sky. Like that. In that direction it should go. If you feel it's too tight, walk one or two feet backwards. If you feel
If you feel it's too tight, walk 1 or 2 feet backwards. Feel it's too far, walk 1 or 2 feet in front. 2, 3, you can take this up further, you can walk 1 or 2 feet further towards the back, and then try to bring the forehead towards the ground and create more opening on the shoulder region. 4, 5, look up slightly, bend your knees, jump in or bring your right leg and left leg forward. Head up, inhale, go down, exhale completely. Inhaling, raise your hands above your head. Exhaling, samasthiti. Steady. Now, Astanga Surya Namaskar B. Samasthiti. Same position, original position. Keep your feet together. Get your shin calf, clean your abdomen. Keep your chest projected forward. And to the side of your feet. Inhaling, go down. Come up. Katasana. Breathing out all the way down. Breathe down completely. Breathing in, raise your head up. Bend your knees until your hands are touching the ground. Jump out or bring your right leg and left leg all the way. Lower your body, chaturanga. Inhaling upward, facing straight mat. Come up. Exhaling downward, facing. Steady. Now bring the right leg forward in between your hands. Your left feet flat, 45 degrees. Inhale, Virabhadrasana. Project your hands towards the sky. Exhaling, hands down. Place it at the side of your right feet. Right feet all the way back. Lower your body over above the ground. Inhaling, upward, facing. Come up. Exhaling, downward, facing. Now bring your left leg forward in between your hands, right feet flat, 45 degrees, inhale, Virabhadrasana. Exhaling, Chaturanga Dandasana, left leg all the way back, lower your body. Inhaling, upward facing. Exhaling, downward facing. Now once again, breathe. If you have already gone to a different depth, when you are doing Astanga Surya Namaskar A, try to do the same, trying to bring the forehead towards the ground. If you feel it's a bit tight, then walk 1 or 2 feet backwards so that you will be able to come even further. Breathe. 1, 2, three, four, five. Look up slightly and your knees, jump in or bring your right leg and left leg forward. Keep your feet together, elongate your neck forward. Exhaling, fold down completely towards the knee. Inhaling, come up, Utkatasana. Chair posture, halfway. Halfway you must come. Yes. Exhaling, Samasthiti. Now, second one. Samasthiti. Come back to the original position. Come back to the original position. Samasthiti. Breathing in, go down, come up, Utkatasana. Chair posture. Breathing out, all the way down. Breathing in, raise your head up. Bend your knees until your hands are touching the ground. Jump out or bring your right leg and left leg all the way back. Lower your body, chaturanga. Inhaling, upward facing, straight hands, come up. Exhaling, downward facing. Steady. Now bring the right leg forward, left feet flat, 45 degrees. Inhale, Virabhadrasana.
Raise your hands towards the sky. Exhaling, Chaturanga Dandasana. Follow instruction. Follow what I'm saying and then do. Inhaling, upward facing. Exhaling, downward facing. Now bring your left leg forward towards the space in between your legs. Your right feet flat, 45 degrees. Inhale, Virabhadrasana. Project your hands towards the sky. Exhaling, come down, left leg all the way back. Lower your body, Chaturanga, hover above the ground. Inhaling, upward facing. Straight hands come up. Exhaling, downward facing. Now breathe. Once again, you breathe. Deep inhalation and exhalation. Deep inhalation and exhalation. Inhale, exhale. The long inhalation and long exhalation. Breath is the king to the mind. If you know how to control your breath, you will be able to control your mind. Three, breathe deeply. Four, five. Look up slightly, bend your knees, jump in or bring your right leg and left leg forward. Head up, inhale, go down, exhale. Come up, Utkatasana, inhale. Samasthitihi, exhale. Now last one. Astanga Surya Namaskar. A. Samasthitihi. Keep your, both your feet together. Engage your shin ka. Pull in your abdomen. Breathing in, go down. Come up, Utkatasana. Inhale. Bring your hands all the way up. Look up. Breathing out. All the way down. Breathing in. Raise your head up. Bend your knees until your hands are touching the ground. Jump out or bring your right leg and left leg. Lower your body. Chaturanga. Utva Mukha. Inhale. Come up. Upward facing dog. Adho Mukha. Exhale. Downward facing dog. Now steady. Bring your right leg forward. Your left feet flat. 45 degrees. Inhale. Virabhadrasana. Look up. Exhaling, Chaturanga Dandasana. Right leg all the way back, lower your body. Inhaling, upward facing. Exhaling, downward facing. Now bring your left leg forward. Inhale, Virabhadrasana. Come on. Exhaling, Chaturanga Dandasana. Left leg all the way back, lower your body. Inhaling, upward facing. Exhaling, downward facing. Now breathe deep. One. Two. Three, four, five. Look up slightly. Bend your knees. Jump in and bring your right leg and left leg. Head up. Inhale. Go down. Exhale. Now come up. Utkatasana. Chair posture. Inhale. Samasthitihi, exhale. This already 3 rounds, isn't it? Okay. Now wipe your face, drink a bit of water. Don't take your phone. All right. Come forward. I'm going to start straight away with explaining about the theme of what we are actually going to study today. So if you want to start taking anything, any notes, now is the time. You can take your notes and then bring it in front of you. Now, why first, when we are talking about meditation, we must know what is meditation. Okay, what is meditation? Meditation means is dhyana. Dhyana is known as meditation. In Sanskrit, it's known as dhyana. What is the state of dhyana? What is the state of dhyana? If you talk about meditation, what we are actually talking about over here? Meditation means concentrating and being absorbed in a particular object for a prolonged period of time. For a prolonged period of time. So, complete absorption into a selected object. ஒரு விஷயத்தை வந்து நம்ம தேர்ந்தெடுத்துக்கலாம், யாரா இருக்கலாம், ஒரு இறைவனா இருக்கலாம். We can choose if you have any god or gurus that you want to follow, if you are following them, then you can select them. So for an example, let's say if someone prays to Lord Murga or someone prays to Lord Jesus or anyone, any chosen idol that you think that they are a representative of God. It could be any object, it could be any object, it could be flame, it could be breath, it can also be breath, huh? You can just concentrate on breath. So concentrating on a particular object for a prolonged period of time without any disturbances, without any disturbances, is known as meditation. Tatra stito yatno abhyasa. Tatra pratyaya ekatanatta dhyana. Dhyana means, Patanjali says, Maharishi Patanjali says, tatra pratyaya ekatanatta dhyana. Means, what does this mean? Is ekatanatta means one-pointedness. Ekatanatta means one-pointedness. Dhyana is one-pointed concentration into a chosen object. This is the definition of meditation. Now, before I explain why we need to do meditation, let me just brief you about the basic meditation. Okay, the state of meditation. Okay, meditation is not something that you can practice. It is something that you have to go. It is a state of mind. Okay, meditation is a state of the mind. What you can do is concentration. Concentration practice can be done, which will lead you to the state of meditation. Okay, we always say, I am practicing meditation, I am doing meditation, I am sitting in meditation. These are all figure of speech. It does not mean that we are actually doing meditation. What we are trying to do is a concentration practice. So when you do concentration practice every single day, you try to concentrate on the chosen objects for a prolonged period of time, eventually it will become poga poga enna aguna, eventually it will become dhyana, means meditation. It will lead you to the state of meditation. I hope so far you understand. Okay, I hope so far you understand. Why must we do this meditation? What is the purpose? I am a very active person. I don't need this meditation. I don't think so. I need this meditation. I am not an old sir. I am a very young youth. Why this? Why you are giving me this type of practices? Now, meditation. Now, all of us are doing asana. Every single day we are doing asana, isn't it? You do asana every day? I don't know. Ask your manasachi, ask your heart, they are doing it daily or not. But you do daily, most of us do daily. Or now, at least in this MCO period, you are joining classes and then you are doing something. You are doing certain practices. Why we are actually doing these practices? One of the main purposes of doing these practices is to keep the body healthy by making the body to work very optimally, to remove all the unwanted toxins from the body also, isn't it? To detoxify all the unwanted things, be through sweat or through the urination or through going to the toilet. All this elimination happens at a very optimum level when you practice asana. When you practice asana or when you practice this any type of exercises or anything like that, what it helps is, it helps to keep your system to a very optimal level, which will help
with the elimination of unwanted toxins or unwanted things from your body நம்ம உடம்புல இருந்து வெளியாக நீக்க கூடிய அந்த தேவையில்லாத பொருட்கள் வந்து நீக்கிறதுக்கு வந்துட்டு இந்த ஆசனா பயிற்சி முறையெல்லாம் வந்துட்டு ரொம்ப ஹெல்ப்ஃபுல்லா இருக்கும் so this asana everything that we practice daily it will help to remove all this from our body by removing all this from our body stays very healthy our blood circulation is good our internal organs are working fine because there are very minimal toxins in the body isn't it now when we do asana we are keeping the body healthy similarly what about the mind are we keeping our mind healthy or not now this is the question that is directly related to meditation now meditation is a technique of if asana is a technique of detoxifying the body meditation or the state of concentration or the practice of concentration is the practice of detoxifying the mind so mind vandu detoxify pandrathu mind vandu clean pandrathu to clean up the mind to keep the mind working at the optimal level that is why you have to do meditation or concentration practice when you are doing asana once the body is cleansed you are everything is working optimally you feel great you feel majestic like that isn't it similarly when the mind is clear you will be able to think with greater clarity heightened consciousness the way that you think the way that you perceive things the way that you can remember memorize your emotional state everything will be in a working in a completely different scale that is why every single person has to practice Dalai Lama has a quote if you are a very busy person you have to practice meditation 1 hour daily I think so I'm not sure about the time but if you are a very very busy person you have to practice 2 hours daily is it because so much things that we accumulate daily isn't it so many things that we accumulate daily அன்றாடம் என்ன ரிகார்ட் from the time you wake up in the morning until you sleep at night how much things that we accumulate in the body in the mind என்ன ரிகார்ட் in the body we accumulate how we accumulate in the body how we accumulate toxins in the body we eat isn't it we eat most of the things come from the what we are eating so we eat it then toxins start to accumulate similarly what we see through the senses what we hear what we speak all these will accumulate unwanted garbage in the mind or toxins in the mind so daily from morning to night we accumulate all this and then we go to sleep we don't do any type of cleansing and then say the next day you wake up again you go you accumulate more and then you accumulate at one point of time even without you knowing you'll start falling into depression lot of sometimes you don't know what is happening to you but you just don't feel good you know what is happening there is too much thing that has clogged your mind ella or clogging aichu so id unclog pandrathukku da it is the practice of concentration or meditation to unclog this you follow me so far Yet, eh? No. See, soften. Don't get, just because I say concentration, don't stop smiling. Eh? You have to continuously smile. Now, how is this mind very important? Yeah, the mind is very important. Why is it important to control? Because this mind will deplete all the good energy or resources in the body. The lower three chakras, in our body, there is 7 main chakras. In our body there is 7 main chakras and then the first chakra is known as the Mooladhara chakra the second chakra is known as the Swadhisthana the third chakra is known as the Manipura and the fourth is known as Anahata now all these chakras are responsible mainly for 3 things one is reproduction means sexual energy. Second is the digestive system. So the energy is either used for sexual, for reproductivity, or the energy is used for the digestive system, digestion, or it comes over here to the heart, Anahata chakra. Here it is used for our emotional process.
So the energy is depleted or goes out of our body. நம்ம உடம்புல இருந்து வந்து எனர்ஜி வெளியாகிறது வந்துட்டு இந்த மூணு மெயின் காரணத்தினால தான், இந்த மூணு மெயின் காரணத்தினால தான் வந்துட்டு வெளியாகுது. ஒன்று வந்துட்டு செக்ஷுவல் எனர்ஜி மூலியமா, from the sexual energy it goes out, and then from the digestive system it goes out, and then the emotional seat. The emotional seat means the center, the heart over here. So if you are feeling sad, if you are feeling overwhelmingly happy, if you are feeling emotional, if you are feeling angry, if you are feeling egoistic, if you are feeling jealous, all these will deplete your energy. But even Gilotas, the person who is controlling all these three things is here. This is the guy who controls these three things. Let's say if your sexual desire is uncontrollable, what will happen? You will always do something that will deplete your sexual energy. Engaging too much in sexual thinking and sexual activities and so on and so forth. Similarly, if you cannot control your senses, if you cannot control, if you go to a restaurant and then you see a rack of food, 2-3 racks of food, and then you cannot control your senses. The eyes are bulging. Thinking, you have not eaten this for 2 months already. I need to get something to restock my body with all this beautiful food. Color, color, udon, color, koli, chicken 65, all these things. I want to take and I want to indulge in this thing. You cannot control your senses. So you eat. You eat, you indulge in your senses. What happens? The digestive system, all the energy that is supposed, that can be used for higher purposes, it gets depleted just by digesting. Just by digest. Some people keep on eating. Their life, actually their entire life, the energy is being wasted on eating only. Because eat, digest. It's like that. This is not life, isn't it? Now another thing. Where is the third one? Does the energy get depleted? In the third level is on the Anahata Chakra, in the center of the heart, the emotional seat. When you are feeling sad or when you are feeling angry, இதெல்லாம் நடக்கும் போது வந்துட்டு you immediately release a lot of energy, get depleted from the body. So the mind, again, what you see or what you hear, if you hear something wrong, then immediately your emotional seat gets hurt. Then immediately the energy gets released. You feel very down like that. There's no more energy in the body. So it is why, in order for all this energy to be controlled and sustained and used for higher purposes, if you want to use all this for higher purposes, have to be able to manage all this energy properly, you have to be able to control this command center, which is known as the mind. That is the reason meditation or concentration practice is very, very important. You follow so far? Okay, is it difficult to follow? No, I've tried explaining in the easiest way. If you really concentrate today, you'll take back something really, really important that you can use it for the rest of your life to lead a very, very high quality life and free from all these issues that is afflicting you in your daily, day-to-day life. Okay, now before you go, let's say every day you want to start practicing for meditation or seek for meditation, what you need to, I will go from the very basic. First thing first, your clothing. You must wear comfortable clothing. Clothing cannot be tight to the body. Tight on a clothes on the body. Clothing cannot be very tight to the body. Means it's tight hugging or the pants are very tight hug. If possible, do not wear anything that is not natural. It is not natural means, what are the things that is not natural? All these yoga pants that we wear. Sometimes, I'm not sure what is the yoga pants material, but I assume it's not cotton. So try to wear something that is more loose fitting, something that does not hug your body very tightly like that, because you're going to do concentration practice. So it is not important for the for you to wear very tight fitting clothes. Romba simpleana clothing ah vandu podanum. ரொம்ப சிம்பிளான க்ளோதிங், முடிஞ்ச அளவுக்கு காட்டனான காட்டன் க்ளோதிங்லாம் வந்துட்டு போடுங்க. சாரிலாம் வேணாம், சாரியோட சாரி
Punjabi suit, I think, can, no problem. You want to wear your own elegant Punjabi suit, you can, no problem. Wear something comfortable. Now comes another important thing. How long I should practice this meditation? You just need to practice for 15 minutes daily, 15 minutes sitting only. And as you practice daily, when you go on and practicing daily, what will happen is you will feel the desire, or you will feel that you want to increase, or you want to sit for a prolonged period of time, because you will feel so good just by doing it. Just by doing it. Now, once that is done, what time should I practice this concentration practice? Okay, this is something important also. You have to wake up before the, before who? Before your appa. Before the world, you have to wake up. Before the world wakes up, you have to wake up. Means you have to wake up early, if possible, as early as possible. If you want me to suggest your time, suggest timing to you, it should be something around 6:30 to 7 o'clock. Something like that. This is the ideal time. But I understand most of you all, I can see most of you are smiling already. 6:30 to 7 o'clock may not be ideal to many of us. May not be ideal to, but you must remember, if you are not able to wake up, or if you are not able to spend time at during this particular time, you must find the time where there is very little distraction outside. Distraction na andha noise irukapadadhu. அந்த இடம் வந்துட்டு நல்ல ஒரு 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 விதமான ஒரு ஒரு கோல்ட்னஸ் இருக்கணும். கோல்ட் மீன்ஸ் தெர் இட் ஹேஸ் டு பி நாட் டூ மச் ஹீட் அண்ட் டஸ்டி ஆல் திஸ் திங். இட் ஹேஸ் டு பி வெரி கிளீன் பிளேஸ் இஃப் பாசிபிள் இன் யுவர் ப்ரேயர்ஸ் ரூம். இஃப் யூ ஹேவ் ப்ரேயர்ஸ் ரூம் அட் ஹோம் தென் யூ கேன் டூ இட் இன் யுவர் ப்ரேயர்ஸ் ரூம். 6:30 ஐ ஆல்ரெடி லீவ் ஃபார் ஒர்க் ஆவ் மஸ்டர். Okay, if you have already left for work, never mind. Don't, you cannot do anything already. Don't do it in the car or while driving, all you cannot do. Come back home later. Come back home later. After you come back, you do it. What is important is don't nariya distraction irukku. Ipo nam meditate senjittu irukom, nam pillinga munna podi varudhu, nam chitti maga vandha nam mela paayidhu. Appo indha maari la irundhuchuna kashtam. Indha maari irundhuchuna meditation varadhu. Meditation varadhu, concentration practice varadhu. So you must, when you are doing a practice, you must ensure there is no distraction, especially in the beginning. In the beginning, when you're practicing, nobody. And don't practice group meditation. Why Gita, nam rendu per sendu seyalam practice appdin naangala sarvini? No, you have to do separately. Separately you have to practice. Don't practice together, because you will start communicating. Unak edhavadhu therinjicha appdin, then the other person will say, ஆமா எனக்கும் இந்த ப்ளூ கலரா தெரிஞ்சிச்சு அப்படின்னு இந்த டிஸ்கஷன் ஓடும். தென் இட் இஸ் ஆல் திஸ் வில் லீட் டு டிஸ்ட்ராக்ஷன் இன் த மைண்ட். ஓகே ஓகே ஐ வில் ஓகே சோ மெனி க்வெஸ்சன்ஸ். ஓகே மாஸ்டர், இஃப் யூ பிராக்டிஸ் யோகா இன் த மார்னிங், யோகா ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆர் மெடிடேஷன் ஃபர்ஸ்ட்? ஆசனா ஃபர்ஸ்ட், யமா நியமா ஆசனா பிரணயமா. சோ பிஃபோர் யூ பிராக்டிஸ் யுவர் மெடிடேஷன், ஃபர்ஸ்ட் திங் யூ நீட் டு ரிமெம்பர் is you must practice your Surya Namaskar and joint exercise. Only Surya Namaskar joint exercise, we can straight go into your meditative practice, into your concentration practice. You don't need to do any other asana. Practice your joint exercises, Hatha Yoga Surya Namaskar, 3 rounds right and left. That is enough. It will take anywhere around 15 minutes. 15 minutes it will take. After that 15 minutes, you can immediately sit for your concentration practice or meditation practice. Now, why you need to do this joint exercise? Because so that the body does not feel very tight when you're actually sitting. How about Brahma Muhurtam? Okay, Brahma Muhurtam is anywhere between 3:35 onwards, 3:35 to 6 o'clock onwards. So you can wake up, if you can wake up, or if you have the opportunity to wake up at that point of time, it is very good. You can start practicing 4 o'clock, 5 o'clock, whichever timing, that is actually very, very good time. Before 6:30 a.m. can meditate like 5:30, yes, 5:30, 4:30, 4 o'clock can meditate, but don't meditate in the middle of the night. It is not suitable. It must be at least 4 o'clock. 12 o'clock, if you start meditating tonight, your family members will be seeing you. So, don't sit at 12 o'clock at night, because that timing is not suitable for
மெடிடேஷன் 12 மணி உச்சி டைம்ல வந்துட்டு எப்பவுமே வந்து ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ண கூடாது. 12 மணி வெயிலையும் ப்ராக்டிஸ் பண்ணக்கூடாது. ஏர்லி மார்னிங் 12 o'clock ஆல்சோ டோன்ட் ப்ராக்டிஸ். மிட் நைட் 12 o'clock ஆல்சோ டோன்ட் ப்ராக்டிஸ். மிட் நைட் 12 o'clock ஆல்சோ ஐ நோ சம் ஆஃப் சம்டைம்ஸ் வில் பி வெரி பஸ்மாங்க பட் ஸ்டில் வெயிட் வெயிட் அண்டில் 3 o'clock 4 o'clock 4 o'clock ஆன்வர்ட்ஸ் இஸ் வெரி சூட்டபிள் டைமிங். Okay, I think I've answered all the same question and similar question earlier than 6:30. Okay, I've answered that. Okay, where was I? Okay, wear comfortable clothing and everything. Okay, do not go into meditation if you are hungry. I wake up first thing that I think of, my object of concentration is breakfast. If your object of concentration is breakfast, first have breakfast. You cannot concentrate on God when you are actually having, when you are hungry, isn't it? You're hungry. So take something light. Take something light. If you want to drink tea, coffee or anything, milk or anything, that will keep your stomach occupied. And it will keep your stomach occupied. Don't go into meditation empty stomach if you feel hungry easily. Because when you go there, your body will ask you, please feed me something. Then you cannot concentrate. Understand? So first bodily needs, but don't follow your desire. Don't follow your desire. Don't have fancy breakfast in the morning. Just simple something that will just help to occupy the body. Fruits or something like that. It's very good. Fruits and everything. So clothing, waking up early or making sure there is no distraction and have something light. This is the core principle when you are trying to do a concentration practice at any point of the time in the day. Now, the technique that I'm going to teach you today is very, very simple technique. This is known as, in the Buddhism, it is known as Anapanasati. Anapanasati means, Anapana means inhalation and exhalation. Sati means is concentrating or mindfulness. Sadina, Anapanasati, A-N-A-P-A-N-A. S-A-T-I, Anapanasati. This is a Buddhist meditation technique, but very, very easy to practice. Anapana means inhalation and exhalation. Sati means is mindful or being mindful over your breath. Being mindful over your breath. This is a similar concept propagated by Patanjali. This is known as Samprajnataha Samadhi. Samprajnataha Samadhi means Samadhi that is using or meditation that is using an object as a point of concentration. Meditation that is using an object as a point of concentration. Or object apathu adu moolima vandu meditate pandrathu. Or object apathu adu moolima meditate pandrathu. This is a concentration. Whatever that I am explaining over here is non-religious. It can be practiced by any person who wants to go or move or find the depth in their own religion. Whichever religion that you are in or whichever spiritual aspect that you are actually exploring in, this will prove to be a very, very useful technique. Now, Patanjali says the same thing, Vitarka, Vichara, Ananda, Asmita, Rupa, Anugama, Samprajnataha means there are various technique. There are stages that you can use by just concentrate. But the first stage is known as vitarka. Vitarka means concentrating on a single object. It is a similar thing that I am going to teach over here. Anapanasati meditation or concentration. Amanda, what is the sadhi in anapanasati? Master couldn't write. Sadhi means mindfulness. 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 Sati means is mindfulness. Being mindful, concentrating. Being mindful or concentrating. Okay. When I'm sitting, how should I sit? It's important also, isn't it? Because when I sit, first I'll be very straight like that in the beginning of the practice. And then what will happen after a while? After a while, this will happen. This, and then it will go down. And then maybe you will sleep already. All the dhyana tripita said, around the like that. So the spine must be kept straight. Why the spine must be kept straight? When the spine is straight, the flow of energy flowing through the spine will not be distracted.
This is the basic principle. I can explain more, but just the basic principle is modern medical science is saying the same thing. The cerebral fluid that is coming from the bottom of the spine, when it travels to the brain, if the spine is straight, it is known to travel in a much more சீரான வேல வந்துட்டு டிராவல் பண்றது வந்து வில் ஹெல்ப் அண்ட் த எனர்ஜி ஈவன் இன் யோகி கான்செப்ட் த சுஷும்னா சுஷும்னா இஸ் த சென்ட்ரல் நாடி இந்த சென்ட்ரல் நாடியில வந்துட்டு த பிராணா ஃபார் த பிராணா ஆர் த ஃபார் த லைஃப் எனர்ஜி டு ஃப்ளோ த்ரூ யூ மஸ்ட் கீப் த ஸ்பைன் ஸ்ட்ரேட் ஸ்பைன் ஸ்ட்ரேட் ஆல்சோ இண்டிகேட்ஸ் அலர்ட்னஸ் அண்ட் யூ ஓன்ட் ஃபீல் டயர்ட் ஸோ வென் எவர் யூ ஆர் லேர்னிங் ஆர் டூயிங் எனி திங் ஈவன் இன் அவர் ஸ்கூல் த டீச்சர் வில் சே சிட் அப் ஸ்ட்ரேட் சிட் அப் ஸ்ட்ரேட் தென் ஆஃப்டர் அ வைல் வில் கோ டவுன் லைக் தட் But why the teacher is saying sit up straight? Because when you are straight, you will be alert. Whether you like it or not, you will be alert. Like that. When you are driving, if you drive like that, after a while, you will feel sleepy. If you keep your spine straight, keep your seat straight, then you always feel alert. Understand? When you are feeling sleepy, what is the first thing that most of us will do? You will adjust the seat and then bring it up straight, isn't it? Should have done that in the first place, isn't it? You won't feel sleepy. Okay, anyway, go back. So keeping the spine straight is going to be important. Can I do it in the sofa? Sofa la ukanda konja comfortable irukum. If you feel that you are going to sit for a prolonged period of time, in the beginning, especially for the people who do not have any issues at all, in the issue of back pain, edhume illa, do not use any support. For those who need சில support இருக்கு எனக்கு வேண்டும் எனக்கு தேவைப்படுது I feel there is a back pain or I want to sit a bit more comfortably, you can sit in your sofa. But not recommended for almost 95% of you all here. 95% of you all I don't recommend. Sit without support. You are your own support. You must learn. You must train yourself. Understand? Because when you are depending on something to do your meditation, I need sofa. And then you go to your party's house, Deepavali. 1 week you went party's house. Or you went somewhere, traveling. You cannot find the same sofa. You cannot find the same sofa. What you will do? You will say, if my sofa is here, I'll be doing 1 hour meditation. Sofa la na pochi. Illati. We will do that, isn't it? We will start giving reasons because we are dependent on something. Sometimes they say, hey, enga da sofa iruke, you can use this sofa. No, that sofa, my sofa is important. Similar, isn't it? When you want to sleep, yen bed la paduthaala adu thookame thani thookam amma illaya inge velila paduthaala yen bed la padukura thookam mari engum kadikadhu andha mari namakku thonum adu pole da dependency create panna koodadhu. A yogi must always be independent. He is not dependent on any external circumstances to make him happy or to make him joyful. Nothing. What is inside him will make him joyful already. Ananda. Ananda means what is inside here will make him joyful. Now, that part is done. Now, what is this anapanasa? Sit in any seated postures you can sit. You can sit in any seated postures. For an example, if you want to go and sit in the most easiest position to sit is known as Sukhasana, right leg over left leg, and then you will pull back. Okay, you will pull back. But there will be a tendency for you to lean after a while. So, I will teach you two positions that is very, very good. First thing is known as Siddhasana. Siddhasana is pressing the heel towards the perineum. Okay, perineum is the space in between the reproduction organ and the rectum. Space. Pressing the heel, the left heel, and then the right leg will be on top of your reproduction organ, like that. Okay, this is for male. Angalukke. This is known as Siddhasana. So when you sit, this is the position. So the ankle will be on top of the other ankle. In the beginning, you may feel uncomfortable, but after a while, you will get used to it. You must practice all this. So like that, you will see. For the female, it is known as Siddha Yoni Asana, means slight difference, as in this ankle will be placed sideways like that. This ankle will be placed not on top, but will be placed sideways like that. This is for the female. is known as Siddha Yoni Asana. Yoni means is reproduction organ, female reproduction organ. So this is for the female, this is for the male. The best position is always Padmasana. Padmasana is the best position. Okay, this is the best position. You'll always keep your spine straight. Why you are doing all these practices is to get very flexible leg and body, so that when you sit, the body is not distracting you in any under any circumstance. Feel comfortable. How many hours you have to sit like this also, you should not feel any discomfort. Now let me see, there is questions here, let me answer. During menstrual cycle, ladies can meditate, sometimes difficult to meditate because during your menstrual cycle you are supposed to rest. Even your asana practice, I do not recommend you to do asana practice other than joint exercise. It is enough. Other than that, you don't need to do. You are not supposed to do, because sometimes it can cause, if you do it wrongly, it can have different effect on the body. Where effect kondu varadhu vandu vaipirukke. So unless you are practicing for many years, you understand the depth, a different depth in your body, then you can start practicing. Otherwise, I wouldn't recommend. So meditation also is the same. In the beginning, if you feel too much pain, you are not able to sit in a proper position, then I would not recommend you. When the pain subsides or when you feel more comfortable, then continue your meditation. It is completely fine. Okay. Why different for male and female? Okay, why the sitting position is different for male and female? It's because of the biology of the body. The way that the body is, we are born with different organs. We are born with different organs. So it has to be stimulated in different ways. So the touch point for the ankle on top to control the sexual organs for the male, because we sit in between. For the female, the ankle on the tip side by side, because it is the touch point that will also control the sexual desire from arising in the body. That is Siddha Asana. And there is Siddha Asana. No pains can meditate. If no pains, can I meditate? Yes, no pain, you can meditate. If you feel no pain, in your menstrual cycle, first day or second day, you feel no pain. You're feeling comfortable. Go for it. There is no issues. You can meditate. You can use this. Okay, I hope all of you are not following this thoroughly. Okay, now I was talking about this meditation, or what is the very simple technique, what you need to do. When you are sitting, I will just go through, and then I will guide you in the practice as well. Okay, what you will be doing, of course, as I said earlier, you sit in a comfortable position, in Siddhasana, Padmasana, any position you feel comfortable. And then from there, you will just start observing your entire body. Scan through your entire body. Scan through your entire body means when you sit, you have done your asana, and then you are just sitting calm, you are sitting. Your hands, how should I place my hands? Should I place it extended like that, or should I... How should I place it? You might wonder. The best position for you to do this particular type of meditation is conjoining the hands like that, in this sense. And the thumb will be pressing on top also, like that, pressing each other. I'm not sure if you can see me. This, I like that. This is the best position that you can use. This is the best position. So this will ensure a circulation of energy. The prana sakti vandittu inda udambla circulate panikitte irukkiradhu. So the prana to circulate again and again in the body, this will be very useful. Since the object of concentration today is going to be breath, all of you are actually going to follow the breath. So now best thing, which is non-religious, which is non-sect, which is just beyond creed or race or anything, is breath. Breath is universal for everyone. So if you don't know what is the object that you want to contemplate on or concentrate on, follow your breath. Okay, so like that, you'll keep it like that, and then you'll sit. in a comfortable position, and then you scan through your body. This, place it on top of your feet like that. Just place it on top of your feet. Okay. And then you will start scanning through the body. You scan through the body from the toes. You start scanning. Okay. Is there any discomfort in my toes? Is there any discomfort in my ankle? On my shin? My thigh? Okay. I feel there is a bit of discomfort in my thigh. Now I'll just focus on that particular area. If I need to readjust myself physically, so that I feel more comfortable, do it. Okay, I feel a bit uncomfortable on my thigh. Okay, I just a bit. Okay, now I feel comfortable. Scan again. Okay, thigh, I'm feeling fine. And then the abdomen. Okay, I feel my abdomen is too much forward. Okay, let me lean back slightly, make it more comfortable. I want to relax my shoulders. Relaxing the hands. And then you will come up until the face. When you come to the face, here is an important point. You must always remember to, this is the keyword, you must soften your face. You must soften your face in the keyword. When we go into concentrated pressure, all are on the serious side. All the full of you, like that, it will go. If you're serious, you cannot maintain. You cannot go into concentration. So you have to have a very calm, composed face. Those who meditate for a prolonged period of time, you'll see their face as a different glow. They are always calm. There's a certain amount of calmness in the way that they do things or in the way that they say things. Okay, now soften your face. Soften your face. After softening, okay, now first thing is scan through. So scan through is done. Second thing, you will take 10 deep inhalation and exhalation. 10 deep inhalation and exhalation. Inhale. Exhale. Like that. 10 deep inhalation, exhalation. After 10 deep inhalation and exhalation, you will continue doing a few more, five more. Take 5 more inhalation, exhalation. But this time, the exhalation will be more than the inhalation. So let's say if you inhale for 3 counts or you inhale for 5 counts, 5 second vandu inhale pandringa, you inhale 1 2 3 4 5, exhale panumbodhu 10 second vandu exhale pannom, 10 second exhale pannom. So you'll exhale 1 2, you're exhaling now 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. And then you will inhale 5 again. And then exhale 10. Like that. Keep a count in your mind. It is okay. Keep a count in your mind. It is okay. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Long exhalation. Soften your face again. Keep a light smile. Like that. Okay, so long inhalation, short inhalation, double the exhalation. Okay, and then after that, your mind will enter a certain state of calmness. Here begins the practice. Now you will just close your eyes halfway. You can close your eyes halfway or you can close your eyes completely. You'll close your eyes completely and then just observe your breath. Even though your eyes are closed, why the short and long master? Okay, wait, I'll answer this question. Okay, you'll observe your breath. You'll observe your breath. You'll observe your breath. You'll close your eyes and then you will notice that you are inhaling and exhaling. Just observe the inhalation and exhalation only. Just observe that. Don't concentrate like that. And the Puruvathilanada, you must always keep your face soft, calm, and then keep a light smile. See my face, huh? Can you see my face? I'm doing a bit of drama. This is reenactment, huh? This is not real medicine. So you must see my face. Later I send you selfie. Maybe you can see much more clearer.
Okay, so you'll keep. So you'll soften your face. Let go all the stress in the cheek and everything, and then just keep a light smile on the face. Okay. Punita? Okay. Understand? Very good. Okay. Now, why the long inhalation and exhalation? Yeah, when the inhalation, okay. When you take more inhalation and shorter exhalation, it will give you energy. It will lead you to a state of higher energy when you take more inhalation and less exhalation. Okay? When you take less inhalation and more exhalation, it will lead you to the state of relaxation. You understand? If the inhalation is longer, it will energize your body. It will give you energy. When the exhalation is longer, it will relax your body. It will lead you to the state of relaxation. This is known as Vishama Vriddhi and Samavriddhi. Vishama Vriddhi and Samavriddhi. You just need to remember, inhalation, if I do inhalation, you won't be able to enter the state of calmness, and then you won't be able to do concentration practice because your mind, your body is not relaxed. But when you do more exhalation, you will be able to concentrate on your breath. Understand? Okay, Ratna? All right. Now, this part is done. Exhalation is done. I ask you to concentrate on the breath. When you are concentrating on the breath, after that, you don't need to do anything. No philosophy, nothing. Don't think about anything. You don't need to think about anything. But everything will now come out of your mind. Now, a lot of things will start coming out of your mind. Palai palai nyavu. Anju vasathuk munnadi nadandhathu. Rendu vasathuk munnadi nadandhathu. All these things that has accumulated over your lifetime, from a very young age, over your lifetime. Unga appa adichathu, unga amma adhu pesinathu, enga thatha appa sonnathu, paati appa sonnathu, enga paati mela paasama irundhathu. All this emotion will start coming out. You will start thinking about the person that you have not even know, that you have forgotten about them for a prolonged period of time. But all this memory has been embedded in the mind. Now you are doing housekeeping. You are cleaning out. Now, when you observe the breath, all these memories and thoughts will start circulating again. Now, when these thoughts come, it will come in front of you like that. It will come in front of you. Do not engage any of the thoughts. Remember this thing. Do not engage any of the thoughts. Means someone that you're close to, very close to, your best friend or your family members, anyone, and the thoughts or memories is coming out once again. Thoughts or memories coming out. Do not engage. You remember your grandmother cooking for you very beautiful, a very tasty meal. Now that is coming. And then you engage. Aamala, paati appadi samichu kodupanga enakku. Appadi ni engage panninga, breath poirum, meditation poirum, ivlo nara okkandhu cotton thuniya pottu idu pannadhu ellame pochu. Enna punninga ellam poirum. Or saapaadukku nala aasapattu. Adhu andha saapaadu anga kulla illa. So you must remember, don't just, if you feel there is anything that is coming on the mind, you're just going to sit and bring back the mind. The mind will wander around again. It will start to wander around again. Again, bring it to your breath. Observe the inhalation and exhalation. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale. One thought is coming in, you will just observe like a third party, like it is not something related to you. You will not even process it, nothing. In the beginning, all this is going to be difficult, but you have to cultivate this. You have to cultivate this. Keep on observing your breath. Mind anganga poguda, adu idu yosikida, again bring it back to your breath. Again, bring it to the breath. Sit for a minimum of 15 minutes like that. In that thing, sit for a minimum of 15 minutes. The inhalation and exhalation should be through the nose, mouth, or both. It should be only through the nose. Only nose has to be used for breathing. Mouth is for speaking, speech, and eating and smiling. That is mouth. And the role of mouth is not to inhale and exhale. The role of the nose is to inhale and exhale. Okay, Umul? Okay. Okay, I've answered all these questions. Can we do shavasana after meditation or require? After meditation, you will feel so energized, you don't need shavasana anymore already. Shavasana is revitalizing the body, re-energizing the body. If you feel that I want to go into meditation, if you feel that I want to go into shavasana, you can. But will it help? No. Will it help anything? But if you feel that your body is tired or something like that, you want to go into shavasana, you can go into shavasana, no problem. But after you practice this, you must practice this, try practicing this for a minimum of 21 days. 21 days continuously, you sit 15 minutes daily. You will notice great changes, just the way that you feel about yourself. What happens is all these memories that has been embedded in your mind all this while will start coming out. And then since you are not engaging them, it won't store back inside. It will just float away. Now all this cleansing will start happening. So many, many things are going to come. Simple, simple things will come. Like, okay, what you're going to do next? Now you're sitting here, meditate, you think you're a yogi. Challenge lang panno. Do not engage, keep calm and then keep composed. Lot of things will come and challenge you. Food, your mother will come. That's why I said no distraction. Your mother will come. Don't get distracted. Understand? All types of things. When you are trying to do something very good in your life, you will have so many challenges. I think you all know that, isn't it? I think you all know that. Okay. Can we listen to meditation music? No. Your music is your breath. You don't listen to any other distraction. Music is a distraction. So you don't listen to any music at all. Because if you listen to music, you will start processing the music. Oh, it's a nice music. It's a very beautiful tone. I feel good listening to this. This processing ready. How long is recommended for a beginner to meditate? Minimum 15 minutes. Minimum 15 minutes you sit for 21 days minimum. You will start experiencing the magic of just sitting and observing the breath. Anapanasati meditation or Sampratsnadaha Samadhi. Just monitoring the breath, mind being mindful over your breath for 21 days continuously. When you cultivate this every single day, you will start noticing big changes happening. Just observing the breath. When you feel good, you will want to extend the timing. You can sit as long as you want, but don't sit too long. You have job to do. You have a lot of worldly activity that you need to engage. What is the maximum you can do? Up to 1 hour you can sit in one session. Can I do like 15 minutes? I'm not able to do today. Tomorrow also I'm not able to do. Can I do on Wednesday 45 minutes one shot? Nahi beta, nahi. Cannot. Like that, cannot. You must do 15 minutes daily. You cannot eat for Monday and Tuesday on Wednesday. Isn't it? Monday and Tuesday, I don't eat. Never mind, I eat one shot. Wednesday, I will eat. Cannot. Similarly, if you need to be effective, continuous practice over the 21 days period. Let's say if you have menstrual cycle in between, you cannot practice, never mind, skip for 1 or 2 days, then you can do. After Hatha Yoga Asana, then meditation. After meditation, can we continue your asana? After your meditation, you can continue doing any activities that you find suitable. If you want to go on with your going working or going doing, you want to continue doing asana practices, no problem, go ahead and do it. But this time your asana practices will have more clarity when you are practicing. I hope I have explained very clearly. And if you still have a lot of, I'm sure you will have a lot of questions, you must come and speak to me. I will let you know what you need to do later. Let us practice first. I'm going to shorten the practice now. And then just so that you know what you need to do when you are doing it later on. This session is recorded, so you can always come back later if you want to check out how to do this or any instruction that you need to do. Okay, so far? Okay, sit in a comfortable position. Keep your spine straight.
in any position that you find suitable, find straight. Your hands, you place it just like how I said it just now. All this will feel very new to you. You may even feel awkward, but do not worry about it. This is the beginning of the practice. Now, scan through your entire body. Soften your face first, soften your face. Close your eyes, and scan through the entire body. Scan through the entire body. From the toes, the ankle, the knee, the thigh, the abdomen. Notice if there are any discomfort. There is, just observe that particular area and adjust yourself if you need to. Otherwise, just concentrate your energy and feel like that particular part of the body is relaxing. And that might be relaxed. Observe. Relax your shoulders. Do not engage your shoulders. Keep your neck, soften your neck. Soften your face once again. Now take 10 deep inhalation and exhalation. 10 deep inhalation. 10 thada moochu nalla iluthu nalla vidunga. 10 deep inhalation and exhalation. 10 deep inhalation and exhalation. 10 deep inhalation and inhale. And then exhale. All this might be difficult in the beginning, but you will eventually benefit greatly out of this. And deep inhalation, exhalation. Don't move your body. Just keep it straight, stagnant, stillness. And after that, now continue taking inhalation, but the exhalation will be 2 times longer. Count in your mind. But soften your face, keep a light smile on your face. Light smile, light smile. You're feeling good in this practice. Light smile. Light smile. You inhale for 5 counts, you must exhale for 10 counts. As much exhalation as possible. Exhale completely. Don't force your inhalation, just soft inhalation. But exhale completely. Exhale completely. Observe my instruction. Keep your eyes closed. Keep your eyes closed. Observe my instruction. Now lower your gaze, even though your eyes are closed. Lower your gaze and concentrate on your breath. Concentrate on your breath. The inhalation, the exhalation. Lower your gaze and concentrate on your breath. Observe the inhalation and exhalation. Observe the inhalation and exhalation. Now many thoughts might start coming in, even about this session itself, even about my voice, even about anything, what you're going to do next, a lot of thoughts will start coming in into your mind, a lot of activities, actions, so many things. Do not engage, keep your mind focused on your breath. Keep your mind focused on your breath. Observe the inhalation and exhalation. Any thoughts, any distraction, anything that arises out of your mind, do not engage any part of it. Do not engage any part of it. Just observe. Now come back to yourself, take a deep inhalation, take a deep inhalation, and then exhale. Once again, take a deep inhalation, and then exhale. Bring your palms together, rub it in. Place it on your eyes, your face, soften your face. And your entire body. Once again, on your eyes, your face, shoulders, entire body. Okay. Due to the lack of time, we did not do it for a prolonged period of time, but I can see that you understand the process. Can you understand the process? Do you understand? Do you follow me? The process is very easy, isn't it? It's very easy. It's very straightforward and very easy. But the implementation will be a bit difficult. I noticed some of us also, when you're doing, you'll start feeling restless. Master, Kalambitaro, Abrino, Sele, Tonirgo, and Marie, Dal number of Kandamur Sultan Daling, which called a paper set a captain. Even Tonirgo, and Marie, Adanala, is on the letter, say, could have Sondamavi number say no. On the Mayan number say no. 15 minutes you have to sit daily. You can put like a timer, you have a application in your phone, you put, okay, after 15 minutes, you beep. Beep. But don't open your eyes and then see whether it is blipping or why it's not blipping. Sometimes you will feel that you have sat for 15 hours, but upon our 5 minutes, 5 minutes, don't do anything. Just sit, close your eyes, observe, be patient. Be patient. Be patient, patient, observe. After 15 minutes, you come out of it. Come out of it, wrap your hands. Place it on your eyes and then go about and then do your daily task. Those who do this daily, if you do this daily, I can tell you for within 21 days, you'll start not even within 21 days. Depending on your emotional condition or your mental health, you should feel the difference even earlier. But in for an average person, within 21 days, you should feel a profound changes in the way that you perceive the world, in the way that you perceive things around you, in the way of your how your emotion is. Everything will change. The way that you perceive, the way that you do things. Can we put timers or we do not keep time? Yes, yes. Kajol, you can put your timer. You can put timer. After 15 minutes, there are some students who will put this. There is an app that will also give you like a bell sound. Bell sound and, singing bowl. Singing bowl. So, when you are starting to starting your practice, you can set, okay, singing bowl, it will start. And then you will go into your practice. Adjust yourself and then scan through everything you do. After 15 minutes, it will ring, ting, like that. Not like my voice, but it is like ting, like that. So it will come out of it. You'll come out of it. Keep calm. And then just observe and see how good you feel about yourself. Okay. All of you, do you learn something very new today? Okay, do this very, very important thing. We have learned a lot of things.
I know a lot of asana also. I've jumped in here, jumped in there. Everything is important to detoxify the body. But this guy is a very tricky guy. You have to tackle him in a different way. But those who have control over the mind will have control over their life. Mind la control irundhuchna, life la control irukum. Mind la control pandrathukku tools vandu breath. So breath controls the mind, mind controls the cause of our life. You start concentrating on the nostril, on the breath. Not 15 minutes from when you start preparing your mat. Not like that. அதுலயே ஒரு 15 நிமிஷம் முடிஞ்சிடும். So 15 minutes after you start concentrating on it. Okay. I think we are done for today. Today is whose birthday? Ratna's birthday today. So Ratna, I wish you, where's Ratna? Ratna is here. Ratna, நீங்க எப்பவுமே சந்தோஷமா மகிழ்ச்சியா உங்க வாழ்க்கையில எல்லா சிறப்பும் சீரும் சிறப்புமா இருந்து நல்லா இருப்பீங்க. நீங்க எப்பவுமே வாழ்க வளமுடன். And for we are done for today. You can come in back and check back the session again and again in later stages. I will record this and upload this and then put it on your channel by in my channel by today. Nice jippa. Thank you. My jippa I chose specifically today for you all. Okay, thank you for joining me today. You'll always be protected, safe from any harm. I pray that you and your family will always be blessed with abundance of health, prosperity and happiness. I bless you with all my heart. Vaalga valamudan. Stay safe, stay healthy and stay happy. Namaskar everybody. I'll see you all. Bye. Take care. Thank you all. Thank you. Thank you all. See you all. Bye. Thank you. Thank you for joining me today. Thank you for the opportunity.